Hello everybody, my name is Tony. Welcome and thank you for joining me. I'm here with the Everyday Counts program and we have an hour together for chair yoga. So first, congratulate yourself for being here. As far as I'm concerned, that is the hardest thing, is simply turning up. Everything else from here on in is a breeze compared to carving out the time to be here. So you've already done the hard work. Making sure that the chair you're on is stable and comfy, and that you've got a little bit of space around you, and that as you move, you won't be bumping yourself. So let's get ourselves set up to start. If you like the support of the back of your chair, please take it. Otherwise, sitting forward of your chair, even if it's just a centimeter or so, that'll help us to integrate this rising up, this engagement of the postural muscles. And of course, you can come back and forth at any time that you need. Feet set up in a comfortable distance for you. We're going to pick up through those toes, even the balls of the feet if you like, and give those feet a little wiggle and stretch the soles of your feet as if it was the very first time this morning or today that you really paid attention to widening the soles of your feet, lengthening them from heel to toe and across the broadness of the toe mounds. And then set those toes, or set the feet all the way down, allowing the toes to be gentle and soft. Push down through your feet evenly and equally. You might even notice that you push down generally through one foot more than the other, and see if you can balance that out, building up tension, just to simply notice the muscles in your legs start to awaken, and then slowly release that. Send your awareness to your seat. Notice again, just like the feet, if you need to wiggle and waggle a little bit. Rooting down through both sit bones, there's those bony bits underneath you. So if you connect downwards to that, and take a big breath in all the way to the top of your breath, and on the exhale, sit the weight of your upper body into your seat. And we'll do that a couple more times. So letting go, like almost allowing your upper body to kind of sit like a sack of potatoes, allowing the full weight to sit in your seat. We get connected downwards. Noticing once again, if you're sitting more to one side of the pelvis or the other, see if you can even that up, if that feels good for you. Notice if you're sitting more forward with your shoulders forward of your hips, or your shoulders at the back of your hips, and see if you can stack those shoulders over the hips in a way that suits you. And of course, it doesn't have to look a particular way. And these are just suggestions. You can check it out. If it doesn't work for you, just ignore me. Rooting down, feet in seat, getting really connected down to that support. And then we lift up through the vertebrae. So as if each vertebrae could get a little bit of space in between them, all the way to the base of your skull. So the crown of your head is lifting up too. And then rolling the shoulders back and down and allowing them to settle down away from the ears, hands supported in a way that feels comfy for you. And then notice how this feels. Take a big breath in, keep the shape. Exhale, let go of tension. And do that a couple more times. Feel free to soften your gaze or close your eyes as you do that. And that gives you an internal focus. We'll keep that internal focus. Let the breath come back to its own natural rhythm. And then simply ask yourself, how am I feeling in this moment? Let whatever arises come up. And maybe that's emotions, maybe that's thoughts, worries, concerns. Maybe that is physical sensation. Maybe you're trying to tap into the kind of energy levels that you have today. Just allow it all to arise. Sit in that beingness for a few moments. Notice if stories come up with those thoughts, feelings, sensations, knowings. And if stories come up, notice those too, but allow those stories to glide on by. For example, oh, my right shoulder is a little bit tense or tight. And that's because I played tennis and then notice the story and let it go and just be like, huh, come back to the sensation in my right shoulder. I may need to pay attention to that and take extra care today. If any tension has built up, let that go too. See if you can soften in any places that feel a little hardened. And then we start to bring our attention to our breath, our inhales and exhales. If it feels okay to you, breathing in and out through the nose, simply a way to allow the breath to get a little deeper and longer. And some days that's not available to us, and that is okay too. Just breathe in the most comfortable way for you. Otherwise, in and out through your nose. And if you can't breathe in and out through your nose, then notice that too. Without judgment, without the story, just notice that doesn't work for me today. And we start to deepen and lengthen the breath. So deepen the inhale and lengthen the exhale in your own way. And don't try and push the breath. So allow the breath to deepen and lengthen in its own way. You might notice that with every inhale and every exhale, the breath gets maybe a tiny bit deeper or longer until you get to a place where you feel like this is comfortable for you. And then we smooth the breath, and this is what I was talking about earlier. We steady the inhale all the way to the top and we smooth the exhale all the way down to the bottom. And start to notice how your body responds to the breath, the expanding on the inhale and the softening of the exhale. You might feel that in your chest, in your ribs, down in your belly. Imagine your entire torso, a little bit like a cylinder, and is expanding and softening with the breath. And if you imagine that cylinder of your torso, notice if there are areas that the breath is not expanding and softening. And then really pay attention to those areas and see if you can send breath there. As if you could literally send a lung to that place that doesn't feel the breath. And we start to feel the flow of the breath in and out, and the flow of our body responding to that breath. Steadying the breath, smoothing it out. And then we keep that awareness to breath, but let go of any forcing. So if any added breath has come in that pushes you past that comfort zone, then just let that go, let the breath be easy. But we still have that awareness to that expansion and softening. And this is the breath. We'll keep coming back to this flow of breath in and out, this flow of the body and the breath moving together. And we'll root down. Feet and seat will rise from there through the crown of our head. Roll the shoulders back and down, and as they settle down, broaden across the collarbones. Keep that full breath going, that flow of breath. And then we'll take the hands all the way down. Any movement you need to ease things up. Taking those hands into soft fists, we'll circle through the wrists one direction. The flow. Keep the eyes soft or closed. It's a great way to start to tune in. Notice, of course, our awareness always goes to the areas of movement that are most challenging, but also notice the ease in different areas. And then take it round in the opposite direction when you're ready. Probably slower than you think. No momentum here, really slow, controlled movements. And then we'll release that movement, release the fingertips, allow those hands to dangle down. through the shoulders. So we inhale up, exhale down. And again, internal focus, closed eyes or lowered or soft gaze. Keep the breath going. See if you can bring an amount of flow into the movement. Even if there's a whole lot in there that's clunky, and then we'll pause when you're ready and take that round in the opposite direction. Smooth and steady. And one side may be very different from the other, no big deal. And then at the end of the exhale, when you're ready, we'll settle back down, turning the palms towards me, and then inhale, take the palms towards the sky. Exhale, palms come down, back behind you, maybe even turning up. Inhaling, wide, exhaling, down, maybe even back. So rooting to rise here as you continue moving through that rotation through the shoulder, and it takes it all the way through to the fingertips. Keeping the spine neutral. So if you're noticing that you're getting flexion and extension in that spine, see if you can just lift up through the crown of your head and keep the movement through the shoulders. That rotation through the shoulders. On that inhale, the shoulder blades roll towards each other, towards your spine. On the exhale, they slide away. Option to keep the hands down in here. Option to take the arms up towards shoulder height. And same thing here. Noticing if anything is changing in the spine, and see if you can keep that rotation through the shoulders. If you're kind of twisting in and out a light bulb either side. Nicely done. Just opening up through the shoulders. And again, on that inhale, you might notice the shoulder blades sliding in towards each other. And on the exhale, they're sliding wide and apart. Nice. And then when you're ready, you're going to take those hands all the way down. Any flow, intuitive movements, I'm going to take those hands in towards heart center. On the inhale, I'm going to spread those arms, right fingertips high, left low, and then take them back together on that exhale. Opposite arms, left high, right low. Keep a neutral spine here. So I know that the go-to is when we take the hands apart, maybe drawing them back behind you, and then our go-to is sending the front ribs out in front of you. See if you can keep that neutral spine and keep the movement through the shoulders. So on that inhale, yes, spreading the fingertips wide. Yes, maybe even drawing the hands back behind you somewhat, but keeping the spine neutral. So again, we're moving through the shoulders. Keep the breath flowing, the movement flowing, never going past your breath. So we're not holding the breath at the top of the inhale or the bottom of the exhale. That flowing breath, inhaling and exhaling, noticing your body moving with the breath. You've got two more either side. Think about that dynamic tension coming from fingertip to fingertip, all the way over through the chest. And then we'll come all the way back to center when you're ready. Hands coming down, flow and intuitive movement to release any tension. Coming into seated cat and cow. So now we're moving through the spine. If you're sitting into the back of your chair, I highly recommend you come forward somewhat. Rooting feet and seat to rise. On the inhale, as the hands come back, now we flare the front ribs forward as we arch the back. On the exhale, send the fingertips towards or on the knees as we carve out the front body, as we draw the belly towards the spine and the back of the ribs towards the back of the chair. Option to flow with the chin lifting on the inhale and drawing down on the exhale. If you want to get into the neck, And if that's not something you're interested in, then keeping the gaze neutral, keep the breath flowing. On the inhale, fill up the front body. And on the exhale, as the belly draws in, push the air out as you push the ribs towards the back of the chair. Staying for that flow of breath, the inhale and the exhale, noticing how this feels in your body. Mm-hmm. And if there's a particular place that you want to stop in and take a few breaths there, please do. If you haven't already, soften the gaze or close the eyes and really notice the different sensations in your body as you move through cat and cow. Notice the thoughts that come up, the emotions, if there are any, and anything else you're aware of. The flow of the moment. Let's take three more. Last one, stay for that last exhale. And then we'll come all the way back up to center, rearranging yourself should you feel that that's necessary. And we'll take the hands into soft fists, bend at the elbows and take the hands in front of you. Now keep those elbows nice and bent. Option to stay here. Option to send the finger or the knuckles in front of you. We're coming into a twist here. Twisting to the left to start with. I'm going to turn to the side so you can see me. This is the inhale. On the exhale, we're going to draw that left elbow back as if we're holding a bow and arrow. And we're drawing that back and then bringing it forward. Inhaling, staying on the left. Inhaling to forward. Exhaling. And inhaling back to center. And again, hands can be a little bit further down, a little bit closer to you, or if you really want to bring strength into the shoulders, depending on what feels good to you, you can take those arms out. Inhaling and exhaling, taking the gaze over that left shoulder for another three. Keeping especially that right hip pulled back, so we're not shimmying it forward, so we keep that movement through the spine. Stay for one last movement, and then we'll go to the other side. Right elbow towards back in space as you glance towards the right, maybe over that right shoulder. Keep that left hip pinned back. Inhaling and exhaling. There's also dynamic tension through that left fist as it reaches forward, so it's not just hanging out in space. We've got another two on this side. And then coming all the way back to center, allowing those hands to dangle down. Intuitive movements. And then draw the shoulder blades back towards each other just softly so the collarbones widen. This is the inhale, let those fingertips rest. On the exhale, we're sending the right fingertips down, inhaling up, and exhaling to the left. Getting that lateral movement through the spine. Notice if, as you come to one side, the opposite hip heightens and lightens. If that's the case, keep both sit bones rooted down, even if that means that the movement is a little less. That way we really keep the movement through the spine instead of bringing the hips into the equation, which is nothing wrong with that. It's just a different focus. Always adjusting and adapting things, listening to me a little bit at the time and then figuring out for yourself what works. Mm-hmm. Two more either side. Keep the movement flowing. Keep it almost lazy. And then we'll come all the way back up to center. Keep that breath flowing. Hands connected down. Rooting to rise. Take a moment. Go inwards. Notice how you're feeling. And then when you're ready, you're going to take those feet a little bit wider. Feet connected downwards. And again, you can stretch the soles of your feet. Let the feet come down. Toes are light. Knees resting over your ankles. And don't worry about what it looks like or if one external rotation is different from the other. Just allow yourself to feel comfortable and stable here. We're rooting to rise. And then from here, hands coming on top of the thighs or the side of the chair, fingertips inwards. And then from here, with the crown of your head, as if you were drawing a circle in the air, so long spine here. This is very different from the rotation of the ribs, which we're going to come into soon. So, long spine, let those hands support you as you come forward, and then you can use the hands to push away as you come side to side and towards the back. Doesn't have to be a big movement. There's a whole lot going on here as we're focusing on balance. We're focusing on flow of the breath, of the movement. The movement is, of course, within the breath. So if you find yourself holding the breath, come back to stillness, establish the breath again, and then come into movement. We'll take another three, bigger or smaller, whatever feels good to you. And then at the end of the next exhale, we're going to pause and then take that round in the opposite direction. Long spine. So consider as you're circling, the crown of your head is reaching a little higher towards the sky. Chin is tucked in towards the chest somewhat, so the back of the neck is long. Notice how you feel this in your body. See if you can encourage more flow. And there's going to be some areas that feel less like flow. And just take a moment there as you get around to those areas and smooth the breath, smooth the movement as best as you can. Three more. Long spine. So we've got length through the side of the waist. And next time, or when you're ready, we'll come back to center. Hands supporting you once more, slightly different movement, rolling through the ribs. This time, the spine is more undulating, as if we're hula hooping through those lower ribs. And this time, the head is a little more still than before. It was coming around in a circle. Now, we're hula hooping through the mid spine. And that's going to be different for each and every one of us. I highly recommend softening your gaze, closing your eyes, and going inwards. Find as much flow as you can in the breath to start with, and then the movement. Mm-hmm. Nicely done. We'll take another three here. Slow it down if it's getting quicker. And then at the end of the next exhale, we will pause and take it round in the opposite direction. Smooth it out. Listen to that intuition of your body. How does it like to move here? What areas do you need to focus the breath on so you can soften those areas that may be feeling like they're starting to contract? Mm-hmm. Smoothing it out. We've got another three here. Let the movement be what it wants to be. And then at the end of the next exhale, we'll pause and come back to center. Heel, toe, the feet back in. And then we're going to wash the knees gently from side to side, getting in through the hips. If you want to take the gaze or the upper body away from the knees, you can. And then we'll come back to center, rooting down to rise, taking a few breaths in and out, settling any energy that feels like it's bubbled up, settling it with the breath, with your intention, and feeling that start to calm as the breath calms, the body calms. And then when you're ready, for those of you who would like to, you can already start making your way down to the floor. We'll be on our backs, knees to the sky, feet to the floor. If you want to stay in the chair, everything that we're doing can be done from the chair as well. So, for example, when we're cycling with one leg, you're going to be doing it in the chair. Now, gravity is a little bit different here, so you're welcome to support yourself as you do that. Everything we do, just imagine that in your chair, you're just simply lying on your back, and adjust anything to your body and what you need. Resting may be different in the chair. You may need more rests because gravity, again, is pulling in a different direction. And then for everybody else, I will see you down on the floor. Here we are on the floor. So we're going to come all the way to our back, knees to the sky, feet to the floor. Taking any extra softness, any support you may need underneath you. So if you need a folded towel underneath you or maybe supporting your head, please take what you need. Push into your feet, pick your hips up and shift them a little bit further away from your shoulders, so closer to your heels. That way we'll lengthen through the spine. Roll the shoulders back and down towards the earth so we get this natural opening of the collarbones. And then we'll start to take some full breaths in. And exhale, soften that out. Soften the gaze, close the eyes. And start to steady the breath. And then notice your torso expanding on the inhale, softening on the exhale. And if there's particular areas you want to take the breath to because it feels a little hardened, like there's tension there or tightness, then go ahead and take some breaths so we loosen up any areas should we need to. And if this is what you want to focus on, your breath today, and you're feeling like this is enough, then fantastic. Stay. Focus on the breath. You can take the knees together, ankles apart. Give that lower back a little bit of a break. Otherwise, from here, I'm going to draw that right knee in. Give that ankle a little flex. And we're just going to circle through the ankle. It's a great place to do it. One direction and the other direction. And then we'll come back to a gentle flex in that ankle. Spread the toes. And then the hands will come either down by your hips in a cactus or T, shoulder height. And then we'll send that right leg up towards the sky. Now you can keep a nice bend in it or lengthening through the heel as the toes spread wide, coming back towards you. The left foot is connected downwards. And we've got that flow of breath. This is the inhale on the exhale. I'm going to take that right heel a little bit further down towards the floor. Nice and long leg and inhale it back up. Keep it nice and soft. And there's a whole lot going on here. Obviously, as the heel gets further away from you, your core and your torso is having to work and your breath is having to work to keep everything steady. Bigger isn't better here, so keeping that steady breath and that focus on the breath and that smoothness of the movement is way more important than the size of the movement.
So if you can take the heel to hover off the floor, but your breath is unstable, come back to a place where you're kind of compromising between the two. So the breath can keep stable and the movement can flow. Great place to be. Option two, keep that breath flowing, keep the movement flowing. And then option, wherever that heel is coming to as you extend, stay for three breaths. Soften where you can, keep the flow of the breath in the torso. Keep the face soft, back teeth parted. And then on the next inhale, we'll draw the foot all the way up to center and give that knee a bend, give it a little hug. Take a break. And then the arms come back to a cactus or a T or down by your hips. We'll flex in that right ankle, and then from here, you're gonna start to cycle. So it's an upside down, one-legged cycle, bicycle. So what we want is the smoothness of the movement. So allow it to be a natural, intuitive movement for you, as if you're drawing a circle in space with your heel. And if there are areas that it feels less than smooth, take the time and see if you can smooth that out as best as you can. Now, the bigger those circles are, obviously the more you have to work. So again, focus on the breath and noticing what's happening. And then slow the movement down. So no momentum here. Notice the areas that are less than smooth. Pay attention to that. We've got another three here. Flow of the breath, flow of the movement. Always resting if you prefer. And then at the end of the next exhale, so when the knee comes back, we'll pause and take those circles around in the opposite direction. Start small. And again, we want control here, control of the breath, control of the movement, flow. So no momentum. And if there's areas for all of us that feel less than smooth, and there's areas that feel a whole lot smoother. So just pay attention to that and do your best to smooth the breath, smooth the movement. Always adjusting to suit you, making that movement smaller, bigger, slower. Notice where in the rest of your body maybe you're compensating for the movement by some hardening. Take another few breaths here. Two more. Rest whenever you need to. And then draw the knee back in, give it a little hug. And then we'll take that ankle over the top of that left thigh, flexing that ankle to protect the knee. And here we are, we'll thread the needle. Let's stay here to start with. You can always extend that left heel a little further away to make it easier in that right hip. Option to stay here. Option to take both hands to the left thigh as you draw it in behind the knee or in front of the shin, depending on what feels comfortable for you. Shoulder blades are snuggled towards each other so they're not separating. If they are, just bring your hands to a different place or bring that left foot down. So we've still got that opening up of the heart as the shoulder blades soften, the collarbones widen. And we're breathing in and out. Keep that flow going. Notice little adjustments here. So adjusting that right knee a little bit further away from you can really make the big changes in the right hip, the sensations. Keep the breath easy. Get another few breaths here. Can you breathe through your whole torso here, like that cylinder? Keep the flow going. Do what feels best for you. Staying for the last exhale. And then we're releasing any bind we had with the hand. Take that left foot down to the floor, unless it was already there. And then we're going to shift the hips to the right. Arms come in a cactus or a T. And then option to stay here. Now, if you've got any SI joint issues, then I suggest that you unbind those knees, take the knees and ankles in towards each other, take the knees to the left. Otherwise, you have an option here to stay in that figure four and then send the entire shape over to the left, letting the right hip lift up, right shoulder stays as grounded as possible. Can take a bolster, a block, anything under that right foot or outer left knee to support yourself. And we breathe, sending that right knee away from you. Can change the sensation. So the further in towards you, the more probably you're gonna feel it in the outer hip. And then you can get some inner groin as you draw that knee away from you. Allow it to be your movement. And flow once again, breath through the whole torso. Gaze can come over that right shoulder if the shoulder's grounded. Another three breaths here. Taking that breath into places that feel like there isn't breath. Full breath here, in and out, stay for that long exhale. Gaze comes to center and the whole shape comes up to center too. Release the right foot and take the pelvis back to center, rearrange yourself, and take a few breaths here. And then when you're ready, left knee draws in, flex through the ankle, and then we'll circle through that ankle. This is a great place to get that range of motion. And then we'll take it around in the opposite direction. Once we're there, come back to stillness, keep that flex in the ankle. Open up through the shoulders, so to cactus T or hands down by your hips, and we'll send that left leg up towards the sky. Nice bend in that leg or pushing through the heel, spreading the toes wide. Right foot is your foundation here, as is the back body. Breath is flowing. This is the inhale. On the exhale, we're going to send that heel a little bit further away from you. That's the exhale. Inhale, back up to center. And the more you flex that ankle, spread through the toes, the more you're waking up the back of that left leg. So if you don't need more sensation there, keep the knee bent, keep that ankle soft. There's a whole lot of different things you can focus on here, so deciding what feels best for you. Now see if you can keep flow in the movement, flow in the breath. That right foot is there as part of your foundation, as are your whole back body and the shoulders, the arms, everything stabilizing you. Option to keep the flow going here. Option to extend that leg to wherever you feel comfortable extending it and staying for three breaths. Soften the gaze, soften the face, soften the jaw. And take that breath into the torso for another two breaths. staying for the last exhale. And when you're ready, we'll draw the leg all the way up and curl that knee back in. Give yourself a little bit of a hug. Stabilize through the body, through the breath, and then the arms come back to a comfortable place. And we're back to our cycling. So that upside down one-legged bicycle that gets us nowhere. What we want is smoothness of the breath and the movement within the breath. So that flow. So flow not being momentum, so not swinging ourselves around, but it is a controlled flow where we're aware of what's happening with our breath, with our body, and allow that movement to get bigger, smaller, stay the same. You can rest and simply imagine the movement. Keep that right foot there as foundation. Notice what's happening in your back body to compensate for the movement. There'll be slight adjustments here and there as your weight distribution changes, as you extend the leg and bring it in. We'll get another three here. Pause and take those cycles around in the opposite direction, smooth and steady. On this side, probably you will feel, this direction will probably feel a little less smooth because we always do our favorite direction first. Notice if that right knee is doing a whole lot of wobbling, keep it as stable as you can. The rest of your body as stable as you can, and if that means making the movement a little bit smaller, then go ahead. Got another two here, smoothing it out, the breath, the movement, the thoughts, the feelings. And then we'll bring that knee in towards your chest, give it a little hug, let the breath settle, let the energy settle. And then we're taking that left ankle on top of the right thigh. Extend the right heel away. If that's too much for you, flex in that left ankle to protect the left knee. Great place to be right here, breathing into your entire torso. If you want to add on, take the hands to the outside of the right thigh, underneath the knee or in front of that shin. As you draw the right thigh in towards your ribs, both ankles are flexed here, both feet flared. That way you protect the knee. And here we are, thread the needle. The smallest adjustments make the biggest difference. So maybe adjusting that left knee a little bit further away from you, or taking the entire shape of 1 or 2 centimeters over to the right can make a big difference. And keep the breath flowing. Keep your awareness on this moment. So the breath, the flow, the sensations. Breathe into any area that feels hardened. Change up the shape if you're getting uncomfortable. Ease the breath, ease the movement. If you need to do less, please do. Got a couple more breaths here. You can always stay longer. You can always come out earlier. This is your practice. And when you're ready, release the hands and take that right foot down to the floor. Option to stay here or take another twist should you need to. Or picking up the hips and shifting them to the left just a little. Keep the shape, keep that flex in the left ankle, take the whole shape over to the right. Right hip lifts, left hip lifts completely. You're coming to the outer right hip here. We're getting length through the left side of the body. Left shoulder is grounded. You can, of course, use as many or props as you need. Make this comfortable. If it's not comfortable for you, then please take another twist. And we're breathing whole torso breath here. So that cylinder expanding on the inhale, softening on the exhale. Soften the face. Adjust whether you want to draw that knee up towards you or take it a little further away. You can always use a hand to assist you. But keep the breath flowing. Keep attention on your body, what it needs, what it's asking for. Breathe into the places that feel a little bit stiff, a little bit stilted. And then when you're ready, gaze comes to center. And then the entire shape comes up to center too, releasing that left leg, bringing your hips back to a neutral place. We'll take those feet as wide as your mat, keep the arms wide also, and then we'll wash the knees from side to side. A slightly different movement. You can send the knees all the way to one side and then all the way to the other, or keep it nice and small, your choice. And then we'll come all the way back to center when you're ready. Feet come back in, lengthen the pelvis. Once again, a little bit away from your shoulders, so we're lengthening through the waistline, through the lower back, and then we're curling those knees in one at a time. Give yourself a hug, rocking and rolling from side to side. And from here, happy baby. So the knees come wide towards the armpits. Take hold of those knees or thighs, wherever they're comfortable. And this is a great place to be with that wideness through the groin. An option to stay, option to send both feet up towards the ceiling as if you're in a little bit of a squat here. Flex through the ankles, forward through the toes. Take the outer thighs, outer shins, or maybe the outside of the feet with your hands. Draw the shoulder blades towards each other. So once again, we've got those wide collarbones. And breathe into that happy baby. In stillness, you can always take some movement, some rocking forward and back, whatever feels good to you. Imprint the lower back and the pelvis on the mat as you broaden across the collarbones. It's another slight adjustment to open up through the groin, through the front of the body. And can you breathe into your whole torso here as a cylinder? Notice the rising and falling of the chest, ribs, and belly. The side of the ribs, but also the back of the ribs on that inhale. The ribs pushing down to the earth. Releasing the bind of your happy baby if you had it. Taking the heels back towards your seat. And then drawing the knees slowly in towards each other. And just taking a little rock and roll from side to side. And when you're ready, feet coming down to the floor. Option to take the knees in towards each other, heels wide. And we have a focused rest here. So giving the lower back a bit of a break with the knees up. Or from here, coming into your relaxation. So maybe the legs go long, maybe you support yourself underneath the knees with a bolster or a pillow. Starfish it out if you prefer to be on your back, on your belly. If there's somewhere close by that's more comfortable for you to rest in, please take the time.
And as you get yourself settled in, tune in to your body. See if you can allow yourself to get as comfortable as you can here. The more comfort we have in our body, the less distraction we have in our mind. Yoga is not about endurance. It's about offering yourself what you can in the moment. So the circumstances and finding the flow within that. Feel the connection down to the earth underneath you. Take a breath into the top of your breath and exhale it out. Settle into that and take a few breaths for that to happen. Imagine your bones just connecting downwards, getting a little heavier than your bones have ever been before. And then let the breath soften and trail away into its own natural rhythm. The flow of the breath. And notice your rhythm of breath here as your body is connected downwards. And start to use those exhales to release the joints. So the joints in your hands soften and wrists. And those exhales, your elbows start to release. And the shoulders relax. And your jaw gets soft. And then imagine the vertebrae of your spine getting a little bit of space in between all those vertebrae. All the way down to the tip of your tailbone. And inviting softness into your hips. Releasing tension in your knees. And then your ankles, and allowing your feet to start to unwind. And then from your feet, allow the muscles to lengthen and soften. From your feet, as you start to draw your awareness up through your lower legs, muscles relaxing, muscles in your upper legs starting to loosen. The muscles around your hips and pelvis. And the muscles of your lower back and belly softening, unwinding up through your waist and ribs, front and back. And the muscles of your upper back and shoulders melting like butter in the sun. And that softness rippling down through your upper arms and forearms. And the muscles all the way down to the tips of your fingers and thumbs. As your throat and shoulders start to unwind, the muscles of your face relax one by one, bit by bit. Muscles of your temples, around your jaw and the back of your head. Skin as a whole to let go. Notice if there's any tension on the inside of your body, maybe around your organs, and invite that to release as well. As we consciously allow our body to unwind,
to our body to step into relaxation. Which gives those signals to our central nervous system that in this moment everything is okay. And in this relaxation, your body has the opportunity to come back to homeostasis, to regulate itself, to start to offer your body the opportunity to heal. Finding that flow as the breath moves in and out in its own rhythm, your rhythm. The mind glides away into some story or narrative, just notice and then bring it back to this moment. Taking some moments for noticing how your body has served you in the last hour. We normally focus on what our body does not let us do, but flip that on its head and take a little gratitude for what it has guided you through, what it has allowed. And we start to allow that flow to happen, to unravel in front of us, moving from one shape to another, from one breath to another, not needing it to be different. This is the practice we can take into our day ahead, our week ahead, our life. We notice the challenges, for sure. But we also make space for the ease and try and find flow where we can. Breathing deeply into the places that feel stuck or tight or tense. Stay for as long as you like. And this opportunity for self-regulation, healing, ease. Let my voice drift away and over you if you can stay for longer. Otherwise, starting to notice the space around you without needing to look. Notice the support underneath your body, how supported you are. And start to deepen that breath in your own way and lengthen the exhale into a sigh. And even as you deepen and lengthen your breath, allow there to be ease and flow there. And then start to allow movement to awaken your body bit by bit. Fingertips, toes, wrists and ankles, maybe guiding your head from side to side. And allow those movements to start to feel bigger, brighter as you maybe stretch or curl in into a ball. Draw your knees in or reach through your toes. Allow it to be your awakening movements. If you're on your back, maybe drawing your knees in or rolling from side to side with those knees, windshield wiping them, and eventually coming to your side. Keep a flow in the movement as you arise to a place that you want to finish today, want to complete your practice. Enjoy your awareness of this moment as you settle into whatever it is that feels good to you to finish up. Hands in a gesture of closing, whatever that means to you. And we take a big breath in. Exhale, softening the chin down towards the chest. Closing the eyes or softening the gaze. Being aware of this moment, the support underneath you, the space around you, your breath as it moves in and out through your body, and your body as it responds to the breath. And take this practice into your day, your week ahead. We thank you for being here, for your time and attention, from my heart to yours. Deepest gratitude.